हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ क्विक सॉर्ट। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। सो लेट्स सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज क्विक सॉर्ट। फॉर योर रेफरेंस आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग यू अ शॉर्टकट लिंक इन दिस राइट अप कॉर्नर। That will be my previous video or a first video of this video series is nothing but introduction to quick sort. Here in short I am explaining you the quick sort in short, that is quick sort is the quickest method of sorting because it requires very less time or a time complexity is very less. That's why this algorithm is highly efficient sorting algorithm. It uses the divide and conquer type of algorithm because it divides the list into the sub parts, sub list, and it conquers the result, that is nothing but the sorted set of values. And as it divides and the list into different parts, so it uses the partitioning property. It divides, it partitions the array of set of values into a similar arrays, that is in a left sublist and a right sublist. Here mainly in this video session I am explaining you how the quick sort works, how it divides the list, how it works, how it helps us to explain how it works to sort the set of values. All these things I am going to explain you with the with this video session. So now I am going to explain you the steps one by one, and along with this with the simple example I am explaining you how it works. So first of all, what the first step is? First step is to choose a pivot. As I explained in a previous session that there are four different methods from which we can either use to choose the pivot. So I am going to use the choosing pivot element as the first element of my list. So now let's see if I am having this list with me from which I am going to choose the first element as a pivot. Now after this, what is my next step? My next step is to start from the first and go in forward direction till the number is less than pivot. I have to perform this step repeatedly till my number is less than pivot. As I have already chosen the pivot, I have to compare every number repeatedly, and if it is less than pivot, I need to go forward in a forward direction. So now let's see how we are going to do. So first of all, let's compare 10 with 12. It is less, so that's why I move forward. Let's compare 37 with 12. It is not less than 12, so that's why I need to stop at this position. Where I have stopped? Whenever I am at the number 37 is compared with pivot, it is not less than, so I need to stop. I need to go forward for the next step. What is my next step? Next step is, now I have to start from the last, and we need to go in reverse direction till the number is greater than pivot. What we have seen over here, if the number is less, we need to go forward. But here, we are going to move in reverse direction. If my number is greater than pivot, move to the next element, but in reverse direction. So now let's see. Now let's start with 28. Let's compare 28 with 15. Is it greater? Yes, it is greater. Let's move forward, but in reverse direction. So that's why I compare 19 with 15. Is it 19 is greater than 15? Yes. So that's why I again move to the next element, but in reverse direction or in the backward direction. So let's compare 12 with 15. Here we need to stop. So that's why, as I have started from the last and I am stopping at the position 12 because 12 is not greater than 15. So what now next step I have to follow? The next step is, again while going forward or in a reverse direction, if we are not crossing each other, we are yet not crossed with each other, then we have to swap that both the numbers. So which number we need to swap? So here you can see that we stopped at position 37 to go in forward direction, and we stopped at position the number 12 which is present at the position to go backward. So what we supposed to do, we supposed to swap 37 and 12 with each other as they have not crossed with each other. So now let's swap both of them. 37 is swapped with 12 by taking their positions. We supposed to after swapping them, they will look like this. So here 12 is at this position and 37 is at this position. So after swapping, your list will look like this. Now let's move forward for the next step. So what our next step is, after performing the swapping on both the numbers, if the condition is true, that is they are not crossed to each other, we have to go back and we have to again start from the first, that is the position where we have stopped right now, that we have from that same position we need to go forward for the next element by comparing it with pivot. If it is less, then move forward. So now we were at the position 12. Let's move forward to compare 13 with 15. Is 13 is less than 15? Yes, the condition is true. Let's move forward. Let's compare 17 with 15. Is 17 is less than 15? No, we need to stop at this position. So I am stopping at this particular position. Now let's move forward for the next step. As we have already gone forward, now let's move forward for the next step to start from the last position where we were stopped, and we need to go in backward or in a reverse direction till the number is greater than pivot. So now let's apply the same thing. We were at the position where previously there were 12 and after swapping now it is 37. As 37 is greater than 15, we need to move forward. So after moving forward, let's compare the 17 forward, means in this case we need to move in a back side or at in a reverse side. So now let's compare 17 with 15, whether 17 is greater than 15. Yes, let's move to the next element in a backward direction. Let's compare 13 with 15. Is 13 is greater than 15? No. So here again we are having the condition which is wrong condition or a false condition. We need to stop. So we had started from 37, we had stopped at the position 13, and to go in a forward direction we are stopping at 17. Here you can see that we have crossed the position, that is here in to going in a forward direction we are stopping at the position where the number 17 is there, and to move in a backward direction we are at the position where the 13 number is greater than. So that's why we have crossed with each other, we have crossed the position. And if we are crossing the position, this condition will be false, because if not crossed, then we supposed to swap the numbers. But if the positions are crossed, now what we supposed to do, we supposed to swap again. But what we supposed to swap, we supposed to swap the pivot and the last number while reversing the list. So let's move back to the our list, where which numbers you supposed to swap while reversing back, which one is the last number. The 13 was the last number and 15 is the pivot. So there will be a swapping between 13 and 15. So after swapping it will look like this. 15 will be at the position where previously there was 13, and 13 will be at the position where pivot number was present. Now after this swapping, what we supposed to do, we supposed to go forward for a next step. Our next step is, now as pivot has secured a position, we supposed to divide a list into two, and we need to start from the first step again. So after dividing after securing a position by pivot, we supposed to divide a list into two. Here you can see that all the numbers which are present in a left sub list are less than pivot, and all the numbers which are present in a right sub list are greater than pivot. And this is only the aim behind dividing a list or to perform a partitioning on a set of values. So as we have divided our set of values into two sublists, that is left sublist and a right sublist. after securing a position, a proper position, proper and final position of a pivot, result is the divided least. And here you can see that all the elements, though they are not in a sorted way, but they are less than 15 and greater than 15, they are lying in a right sub least. So now after dividing a list, our next step is to return back to choose the pivot again, and again we have to apply all the steps in a divided sub list one by one. That is, first of all, in a left sub list apply the same steps again, and in a right sub list after completion of a left sub list. So the steps of quick sort at a glance are nothing but, we supposed to start with the choosing a pivot element, that is from the first position of the list. Starting from first, we need to go forward till the number is less than the pivot. Why we are going to do, or why we are going to apply this step? Because these are the steps which are going to find out the proper position of a pivot. We supposed to go forward till the number is less than pivot, because anyway the pivot is securing a position, and in a left sub list that all the elements which will be less than pivot, that's why we need to go forward till the all elements in a list are less than pivot. And the same thing we are going to do in a reverse manner, by starting from the last. As we need to find out all the numbers which are greater than pivot, that should be there in a right sub list. So that's why if the number is greater, move backward. If the number is greater, move backward, because all that numbers which are greater than pivot, that we are going to store into the right sub list. So that's why in moving in a reverse direction, we supposed to find out all the numbers which are greater than pivot, and in the same condition, if the condition is true, we supposed to move in a backward direction. But if any number, while moving to the forward direction, if any number which is greater than pivot, and while moving in a reverse direction any number which is less than pivot, we supposed to swap them if they have not crossed their position. Because after swapping, what will happen, the numbers which was there which is greater than pivot will secure a position of a number which was less than pivot in this second while condition. So after swapping their positions, we need to start again from the same position to find out the numbers. If it is greater than less than pivot, we need to move forward. If it is greater than pivot, we need to move in reverse direction. We supposed to perform these steps repeatedly till getting the position of pivot, from where you will get a proper position of pivot at the end, when that after performing both the way, that is moving forward and moving in a reverse direction, if you are going to cross with each other, it means that now there is no any element which is available in your list is less than the pivot in the forward way, and in a reverse way there is no any element which is available greater than the pivot. So while moving in a reverse direction, we are at the position where the condition is false and we have crossed with each other, then we have to swap the pivot and the reverse ordering number. After swapping both of them, the pivot is securing a proper position, and then pivot is divides a list into two, that is a left sub list having the elements which are less than pivot and a right sub list having the elements which are greater than pivot. Now as you are having two separate lists with you, then you supposed to apply the same steps repeatedly, starting from the choosing pivot. So that's why we need to return back, and we supposed to apply the same things again on a left sub list separately and on a right sub list separately. So in this way the quick sort works. So I hope all of you have understood how quick sort works. Here I have not completed the example, this is only the way with which I supposed to explain how the quick sort works. For the detailed and complete solved example, please stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks, and Thank you for listening and watching my video. If you like the video, please do not forget to give the comment. If you are having any query, then also you can post your comment. I'll try to solve your all the queries. Here, I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel Tech Talks. Please do subscribe my channel Tech Talks if till you have not subscribed. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for a next video of this video series, along with the whole playlist in the form of the video series on a quick sort. Thank you and stay tuned with Tech Talks. Happy learning. Thank you.